Hola, muy buenos días para todos. Bienvenidos al segundo día del tercer encuentro matemático del Caribe. Esta presentación del día de hoy, bueno, la segunda del día de hoy, tengo gusto de presentarles a la profesora Enide Andrade, que junto con los profesores Lorenzo Ciardo y Heyerdahl, bueno, en colaboración con ellos, nos van a presentar esta charla titulada Parent Values and Classes of Trees. Eu gostaria muito de agradecer a você, Nide, por sua segunda participação no encontro. É um prazer ter você aqui na terceira versão do Encontro Matemático do Caribe. Então, pode continuar com sua apresentação.
Ok, obrigada, Giovanni. Eu agradeço a possibilidade de me darem esta participação, de poder estar aqui. Eu vou falar em inglês porque é um participante norueguês. Nós fizemos, vou só tirar daqui as. Nós fizemos este trabalho que está ainda submetido, foi com o Lorenzo Ciardo e portanto, o Geirdal que falou antes de mim. Portanto, o Geir é da Universidade de Oslo e o Lorenzo é da Universidade de Oxford. Bom, I will start in English. I will show you a bit the outline of the talk. I will introduce some motivation for what we did. I will introduce you the bottleneck matrices that are connected to trees, and I will present a spectral an upper bound for the spectral radius of symmetric matrices having a specific block structure, and we apply this for general trees and some special classes of trees. And in the end, I will present you the combinatorial Peyron parameters and give you exact bounds for a special class of tree. We use this notation as usually. G is a graph with vertex set V and edge set E. And we know that the Laplacian matrix is the difference between the diagonal matrix of vertex degrees and the adjacency matrix. So this matrix is symmetric. Is positive semi-definite and it has zero as eigenvalue. And there is an important eigenvalue of this matrix that is its second smallest eigenvalue that we call algebraic connectivity of the graph. It was introduced by Fiedler in 73 and it usually is denoted by AG. So, Fiedler in 73 introduced a remarkable result that describes some of the structure of the eigenvectors that are associated to the algebraic connectivity, and this allows to classify the tree into two types, type 1 and type 2. So I will present later the theorem. Well, an eigenvector that is associated to the algebraic connectivity is called a Fiedler vector. What I want to show you is a close connection between these bottleneck matrices, its spectral radius, and the characterization of the trees into type 1 and type 2, and the algebraic connectivity that was given by a theorem from Kirkland, Neumann, and Schaller in 1996. Well, if you want to know more about the algebraic connectivity, you can read a survey from Nair Abreu from 2007, and this book from Molitierno from 2012 that is presented in the list of references in the end of this talk is very good. It has a lot of information. Well, we focus on trees. Okay, so let's show you how these bottleneck matrices appear. We suppose that we have T prime a tree, and suppose that LT prime is Laplacian matrix. So we choose a vertex of T prime, and this matrix LV is the principal submatrix of the Laplacian matrix, that is obtained if we delete the V row and V column of the Laplacian matrix, okay? Well, this matrix is invertible. It's possible to be, so it's proved that it's invertible, but its inverse, it's a block diagonal matrix where each block M corresponds to a rooted connected component that we call branch T of T prime when we remove the vertex V. And this M is called the bottleneck matrix of the branch. I will show you an example. It is better to see. Well, these blocks are symmetric and are positive. And then we can say that the bottleneck matrix M corresponds to a rooted tree T that has a root R that is the unique vertex in T that is adjacent to V in T prime. So let's look at an example. Suppose that we have T prime here. Choose the vertex 3. We choose the vertex 3. We construct, let's look to these blocks here, the matricial blocks, okay? But this results from where? We construct the Laplacian matrix of T prime. We remove the vertex corresponding to 3, the row corresponding to 3 and the column corresponding to 3. The resulting matrix LV is invertible and its inverse is a diagonal block matrix where each block corresponds, it's a bottleneck matrix of the branch T prime. So this is the bottleneck matrix of this branch. This is the root of this branch that is connected to V, and this is the bottleneck matrix of this branch, and the same here. So we can obtain the entries of the bottleneck matrix in a good way. Suppose that we have this tree here. This is the branch that is connected to the vertex V. So this is the root of the tree. So how I can write the entries of the bottleneck matrix? So the bottleneck matrix in this case is a n by n matrix. In the example is a 6 by 6 matrix where mij is the number of vertices that lie simultaneously in the path from the root to I and in the path from the root to j. So let's look at M56 in the previous example. So it's the number of vertices that lie in the path from the root to 5 and in the path from the root to 6. So the number of common vertices is 2. It's this and this. So we have M56 that is equal to 2. So we can obtain the entries of this bottleneck matrix. Well, the Peron value of the branch is the Peron value of its bottleneck matrices. That is, we know that is the spectral radius of M. And the branch at the vertex V that attains the maximum Peron value is called a Peron branch. Okay, if attains the maximum Peron value, it's called a Peron branch. So we are in conditions to present the theorem from Kirkland, Neumann, and Schaller from 1996. This theorem gave a kind of centered prop for the graph that is obtained from the algebraic connectivity. It is called the characteristic set. So what the proof was is the following. If we have a tree, there are only two possibilities. There exists exactly one vertex V with k greater or equal than 2 Peron branches at V. And if these are the corresponding bottleneck matrix, the algebraic connectivity can be written as the inverse of these elements. So in this case, T is said to be of type 1 tree, and V is its characteristic vertex. And there is another, the second possibility is this one. So there exists exactly one edge BPQ, such that the unique baryon branch BP at V contains Q, and the unique baryon branch BQ at Q contains P. And if we consider this, the corresponding bottleneck matrices, the algebraic connectivity can be written as inverse of these elements, where here J is the all ones matrix, and this gamma is between 0 and 1. So in this case, T is classified to be of type 2, 3, and P and Q are its characteristic vertices. So with this theorem, we see the importance of the study of the baryon values of the branches of a tree, because they play an important role when we determine the algebraic connectivity and the characteristic set, okay? So if we investigate the algebraic connectivity through the lenses of the baryon values, instead of calculating the spectrum of the Laplacian matrix, so we have two advantages that are, first, the bottleneck matrix is entry-wise positive. So this gives the possibility to use the Perron-Frobenius theory to study the spectral radius. Moreover, the variational expression for the maximum or the minimum eigenvalue of an emission matrix that comes from the Curran-Fisher-Weyl principle is simpler than the corresponding expression for the other eigenvalues. So in particular, the Rayleigh quotient of M with any non-zero real vector gives a lower bound on the Perron on rho of M. So unfortunately, we don't have many exact values for the Perron values of many trees. So we have from these authors, Kirkland, Neumann, and Schaller from 1996, the Perron values of the star and the path with n vertices, the exact Perron values for the bottleneck matrices. Well, so now I will tell you what I'm going to do. So I will present you bounds on the Perron values of various classes of rooted trees by using some combinatorial and spectral tools. I only present you two tools. And we note that this is important because from the theorem from Kirkland, Neumann, and Schaller, these bounds that we obtain can be turned into bounds for the algebraic connectivity of classes of unrooted trees. So we present one technique. We present a general result on the spectral radius of symmetric matrices that have a specific 2x2 block form, and then we use it to obtain these upper bounds for the baryon value of generic rooted trees and some particular classes. I will not present the theorems, but I only say which classes we deal with. So the result is this. We consider this matrix here partitioned into blocks, where A and C are symmetric matrices, A has order K, C has order L, so B is of size K plus L, and B has a special form. So B can be written like this, where W and Q are vectors. So this means that B has rank at most 1. So for a matrix partitioned like this, note that this matrix is symmetric, so it has real eigenvalues. So for a matrix like this with this form, we obtain this following upper bound on the spectral radius of M that is expressed in terms of the spectral radius of A and C, okay? The bound is this one. And moreover, if you want to calculate if this inequality holds, then this upper bound here in two is strictly smaller than this sum. Okay, So we wanted to apply this in into general trees. So I give you an example here to show how this works. So suppose that we have this tree and this tree that is in black, and this is the root of the tree and shows a vertex P. So consider that P is not a pendant vertex and it's not the root. Consider this subtree here. So FP is the set of vertices that are below P. Below in the sense that the path from the root to any vertex here contains the path from the root to P, okay? So consider the subtree induced by this set and P, and we call it TP. And consider T prime, the induced subtree of V minus FP. Okay, so these two trees have only P in common. So I will formalize now, although this is an example. So we have a rooted tree with root R, and we consider P a vertex in T. And as I said, P is not the root. P is not a pendant vertex. And this means that V is below P, as in the sense that I told you before, that this path is contained in this path. And if you consider FP, that is the number of vertices that are below P, but they are not P, this set is non-empty. And TP denotes the induced subtrees with these vertices with root T, and T prime is the subtree induced by V minus FP with root R. So as I said, and as I show you to you in the example, these trees have only one vertex, the vertex P, in common. So what is good here? If we order the vertices in T such that the vertices here are before all the vertices in FP, so the bottleneck matrix of the tree has this form, that is good. So we can apply the theorem. So A is the bottleneck matrices of T prime. C is a special matrix, is a truncated bottleneck matrices of TP, where the row and column corresponding to P are deleted, plus a constant block. And A and C are symmetric. And more, what is B? I will not tell everything here, but B, each row that corresponds to a vertex U that are in T prime and a vertex V that are in TP is nothing more than this expression. What is this? Is the number of common vertices in these two paths from the root. From the root to U and from the root to P, and it is independent of V. Okay, so each row in B is constant. So B can be written like this, where this E is the all one vector. And what is W? W is this vector, it's nothing more than these numbers here. Okay, so we can apply the bound in the theorem that can old for the Peron value of the T. When we choose Q equal to the all ones vector, this norm is equal to L, okay? So we can do this in this sense. We can add an edge. We have a tree, TP, we have a tree, and this TP is just adding an edge. So we have just this edge, PP prime. So the number of vertices is equal to k plus one, and W is nothing more than this, as I told you before. And if S is the distance of the root to P, we represent like this, and this is the distance from the root to T prime, the bottleneck matrix has this special form here, okay? So the bound is this. So the bound is this beta. So for the, when we had an edge, so if we consider the rooted path Pn, this bound is almost, this beta is almost tight. For instance, for n equal to 21, the Peron value of the path is this expression, is this value, sorry, and this beta is very close. So here note that beta is computed based on the Peron value of the path with n minus one vertices because we are adding an edge, okay? So we want to use this for general trees. We want to present a bound on this for general trees. We know that a tree can be constructed by this general tree construction procedure. We can have a single vertex. We started with a single vertex, that is the root. And so this is the initial tree. And then we had a new vertex successively and attached to the existing tree by an edge to some existing vertex. Okay, so we can apply what I told you before. We are just adding an edge to the previous tree. So that's what I'm saying here. We can repeatedly use the upper bound in the example before. So the tree construction, imagine that the tree construction procedure results into these trees, where T1, as I said, is the root R. And for I between 2 and n, this ti is obtained from ti minus 1 adding a vertex and an edge to the vertex vj in ti minus 1 for some h. So mi is the bottleneck matrix of ti, so this is a bit more formal. Double y is the vector that I told you before when we just had an edge. Si is the distance of the root to Vj, Vh, and then Mi has this form. And if we define recursively these expressions here, where here we it is obtained from the example before, so we have this following corollary. The upper bound on the Peron value of this matrix, also we have this. So in particular, the upper bound for T is less or equal than this row N. So we have a construction, we have this upper bound for general trees with this construction, okay? Well, we obtained upper bound, upper bounds for the spectral radius for broom trees using these results. A broom tree is nothing more than a tree like this. This is a very specific example. We have here a path and then we have vertices and connect to the extreme vertex of the path. So we have a broom tree. I will not present the result. The bottleneck matrix have a nice form and we can apply the theorem. And split graphs, we also obtain a bound for a row of M of split graphs. What are split graphs? Here is a specific one. We have a path with length K and in the vertex S, we append a path of length L. So we call it split graphs. And moreover, we call we obtain a bound for the Peron value for rose trees. What are rose trees? Here I'm showing you perfect rose trees. So we have here a path, and in one of these vertices, we append a star. It is called perfect rose trees if this number here is equal to this number here. So, but we obtain for rose trees. Okay, so we have bounds for the spectral radius of M of these classes of trees using that theorem. Well, I will present you another technique. Another technique is using the theory of combinatorial Peron parameters that we study guided me in 2017. And with Lorenzo in 2019. So this study, the study of these combinatorial Peron parameters was to provide close and computationally efficient approximations of this Peron value. So let's define this. First, I want to define what is the distance of the vertex J is nothing more than the number of vertices in the RJ path PJ. So from the root 2J, it's the number of vertices. And if we denote like this, we call it distance vector. And if we look at this branch here with n equal to 6, the same example that I showed you before, the distance vector is nothing more than this. So the number of vertices to the root is equal to 1. In the R2 path, the number of vertices is equal to 2. In the R3 path, the number of vertices is equal to 3. And these are with 3, the distance is 3, okay? So the distance vector is easy to calculate. So the parameters were this in 2017, we introduced these two. We call it rho c. It is, so here we use this distance vector. This comes from the Rayleigh quotient expression. And this PD of t is this expression. And another with Lorenzo in 2019. So we have this, we call it pi e, and this e here is all one ones vector. So the, these combinatorial Perron parameters, they provide lower bounds on the Perron value rho of m. So, but what is good here is that their combinatorial nature makes it possible to obtain closed formula for certain classes of rooted trees, okay? I will present here, I will give you only the expression. This was tested with MATLAB and MAPLE. In 2019, Lorenzo Geyer and myself presented this combinatorial Perron value for the Broom trees. I only present you for the Broom trees. The expression is not that nice. Then here in this work, we compute this pi of V from the Broom tree. Okay, it is this expression. So there was another class that we studied, but I will not tell you. If you want, I can tell afterwards. So my references for this work and that I presented here, this is the work from Abreu where you can find results on algebraic connectivity of graphs. And these are the three papers. This is the last one that we submitted with this work. These are the results from, you can find the results from Kirkland, Neumann and Schaller. And the book, this book from Litierno that has a lot of information about the Laplacian matrices and bottleneck matrices. So, obrigada pela vossa atenção. Desculpem ter falado em inglês, mas como o gajo estava a assistir, optei por falar em inglês.
Muito obrigado, Nida, por sua apresentação.
Obrigada. Eu posso parar o stop share agora?
Bom, somente alguém tem alguma pergunta? Alguém tem alguma pergunta sobre a apresentação? Bom, tem aqui aplausos.
Ah, muito obrigada. É sempre bom. Obrigada.
Any question?
O que eu queria dizer no fim, que não tive tempo e já agora posso dizer, nós trabalhamos com as Broom Tree e obtivemos valores exatos para as Broom Tree. Também obtivemos para aquilo que nós chamamos regular caterpillars, que são caterpillars em que o número de vértices que estão pendurados em cada um dos vértices do caminho, o número é igual, está bem? Portanto, nós apresentamos também valores exatos para estes combinatorial Perron values. Embora a expressão não é bonita, mas portanto, para estas duas classes de árvores temos os valores exatos.
Bom, pode ser apresentado na quarta versão do Encontro Matemático do Caribe do ano que vem.
Pronto. Obrigada.
Bom, não encontro perguntas aqui. Então, novamente, muito obrigado você, Nida, por sua apresentação.
Obrigada,
e por, como falei, esperamos também você o ano que vem, já com apresentando o último que falou.
O próximo episódio. Obrigada.
Bueno, gracias a todos también por su atención. Los invitamos a que continúen aquí disfrutando de las presentaciones del tercer encuentro matemático del Caribe. En teoría de grafos, pues viene también una presentación de Wilson Olaya y de Yasmín Mantilla de la Universidad Industrial de Santander. Entonces no se la pierdan, estén conectados ahí. Muchísimas gracias y un abrazo para todos.
Obrigada.